Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. In this video, we're going to talk about ketosis and kidney stones, okay? A lot of you are doing ketosis. I'm going to show you what to do to prevent kidney stones, because here's the problem. When you are on a ketosis diet, you do get rid of calcium in the urine more than usual, right? Now, here's the problem. When you're consuming cruciferous vegetables, which I'm always recommending, or spinach, or iced tea, or chocolate, which maybe you shouldn't be doing, all that has high amounts of something called oxalates. Okay, the oxalates combine with the calcium to make stones. So that's the situation. Believe it or not, kale is very low in oxalates compared to spinach. Spinach is off the charts. So if you're doing spinach, then all we have to do is not necessarily avoid calcium. Believe it or not, you want to take some food-based calcium. You want to actually get your calcium from food, whether it's cheese or something like that. Because if you consume dietary food calcium, what happens, the high levels of oxalates, which are you're consuming as well, will bind in the digestive system instead of going through the blood and out to the urine, through the kidney. So in other words, if you're not consuming enough calcium, and I'm talking about pills, actually calcium in food, that's why I do eat cheese on a regular basis. If you're allergic, then you're going to have to find some other source. But the point is that that calcium in the digestion will then protect the kidneys by taking more calcium, so that way it never ends up in the kidney. So that's one thing. The other mechanism for stones is that you're low on citrates. Now, what does that mean? There's a certain thing in the body called citrates, and when you don't have enough of that, you can be more at risk for kidney stones. So that's why I recommend the lemon juice on a regular basis. So I even take, when I do a kale shake, I will pour maybe 2 or 3 ounces of lemon juice in that kale shake. It makes a nice little shake. Or just start putting the lemon in your water. You can do it as just a liquid or the actual lemon, but at least 1 lemon a day. That will also decrease the risk for kidney stones. The other thing is making sure you have enough magnesium. Well, that's going to come from the vegetables, but if you're actually doing a ketosis with not enough vegetables, then you need to increase that to get the magnesium. You can also take this as a supplement too, but I would not take a calcium magnesium. I would take just a magnesium supplement unless, you know, you need calcium. And I have certain videos that explain when you need that, but typically people have a bit too much. They're taking too much calcium as supplements. They're not taking it from the food, all right? So I hope this helped. Go ahead and apply it and leave your comments below. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Please click the share button below and I will see you in the next video.